Hello, host. How is everybody? I want to wait a little bit. Oh my God, Gringo, you're here. And of course, I want to ask you, hello. I know you're not alone, darling, dear Gringo. Peter Curran, hello. How are you? I want to say, first of all, thank you so much for joining me this lovely Sunday afternoon. I am here from Brooklyn, New York. It says that it might rain or not. Maybe not. If you can hear me, please say yes, we can hear you. Hey, Ray from Dublin. Peter, is that you from London? Hello, everybody. Happy Sunday from San Antonio, Texas. Text from Texas. I have my really good friend Jason Evans right next to me, who I've been torturing with this presentation. I'm going to give us a little bit of time for the room to fill up since we have some Katie and Marie from California, Heather from Vancouver Islands. Please let me know that you can hear me. Robin, thank you so much. Peter from Albany. I thought you were my Peter from London since I don't remember his name, his last name. So we have a few attendees. I have a couple of requests already. Okay, so yes, you can hear you. Oh, perfect. So we have the technology gods are with us today since it is Sunday. And I think Sunday seems to be a good night for webinars because I got the most registration. I don't know if it was the topic or because it's Sunday evening. Deborah, if that you are lovely, lovely moderator from New Host Forum. So we wait for one more minute and we're gonna start because I have this huge presentation. I've been like working on this for a week. I've gone through the rabbit hole of cleaning. So I hope you'll have as much fun as I have had and driving all my friends crazy saying like, oh my God, did you know this? And look what you could do with vinegar. I think I'm just gonna buy some stock on white vinegar and just keep it around because it seems like between vinegar and baking soda, that's the tool to use. So the room is filling up. Thank you so much. We have like 36 people already, but let's start. I'm going to share the screen. So first of all, let's start with our lovely disclaimer that this is not an Airbnb sponsor event. This is Evelyn Badia, live from Brooklyn, New York. And even though Airbnb knows of me and of my presence, they are not sponsoring this event. All opinions are mine. I've been an Airbnb host for over 5 years and tons of laundry. I do 90% of my cleaning. Sometimes I do hire some people, and I shared with the subscribers the lovely cleaning document that I've given. And I shared it with my latest cleaning person, and she was like, I'm scared, I'm scared. But it's a good thing, a good tool to have. It's something to let your cleaners know what to do and how to go about it. So let's start with what we're going to be talking about today, which is all about cleaning. And our first thing, we're going to talk a little bit about laundry. And we're going to talk about the bathroom and from a little quick clean because sometimes you got to clean it quickly because your guests are arriving to a deeper cleaning. We're going to talk about the kitchen and there's 6 items that we forget to clean, but they're great to. Yes, it is intentional, Juliet. You're seeing the presentation now. And we're also going to talk about cleaning green. I think it's one of the great things that we could do for our guests and for our pocket. All right, so laundry. E.B. White said we should all do what in the long run give us joys, and even if it's only picking grapes or sorting the laundry. Oh my God, we have somebody from Vietnam. Hello. I love seeing from wherever everybody's coming in, and I'm always very honored that you're taking time to do this. So let's go back to laundry. This is just, and I'm going to share this presentation with you. I will send it to you when I send you the link for the replay and everything else. So you do not need to keep notes. You don't have to worry about it because there's tons of information. I'm not going to go through every slide of, I'm not going to talk about it because I'm giving you way too much information. So your wash cycle, as you know, this is just from your regular cycle to your permanent press. The white loss was recommended at hot water. And I know that because you're hosts and because you follow me, you know that I recommend white laundry, white towels, and white linens for your bedding. In reference to some tips that I have found out is do not fill the washing machine to the top. The detergent and laundry need to mix, and it's better to not be with a full load. So just do a little bit less, even if you have to do more loads of laundry. Pre-soaking is great for removing stains, and I'm going to give you some tips for removing certain stains. And I even have a PDF with a list of things to do with stain removing. Another recommendation is to hang the clothes to dry outside. But if you do that, keep the dark colors out of the sun or they will fade, all right? So with towels, because we're going to talk about what's important to us as hosts, read your label first and wash them before your first use. And I actually do this with not just my towels, but also with my sheets. I don't like the idea that you have things with chemicals or smells and things like that. So throwing them in the wash before using them for the first time is a great thing to do. If the label permits, and if it's white towels and white linens, use hot water. Less detergent is better. Detergent coats your laundry and the wash stops absorbing. Use white vinegar as a softener, and you use between a quarter of a cup to half a cup per wash. So no commercial softener. Everything I've read on the internet, and believe me, I've been doing reading about this for a while, is the towels get less absorbent if you use a commercial softener. They actually coat the towels. Another thing that is good to fluff them is dryer balls or tennis balls in the dryer if you're going to use the dryer. So that beats them and fluff them up. So when you do your laundry and you take out your towels from the washer, it's good to give them a shake, then put them in the dryer and shake them after the dryer as well. All right. So, and also to then avoid any moldy smell, make sure that they're totally dry, because if not, they're going to have a scent. If you're going to air dry your towels, the recommendation is to just shake them as well and probably throw them in a dryer with an air setting just to get them fluffy. All right. Any questions so far, or are we running around? We're good. We're going all about, now we're going to talk about pillows. Even though you use pillowcases and protectors, and I know that you do, the pillows need to still be washed about 4 times per year. Or if you know they're a little dingy or a little smelly, you should wash them as need them. Do a gentle warm wash, and you do a double rinse. So even if you don't have a double rinse in your washer, just turn the knob and rinse them again just to get rid of any soap. Don't use a lot of soap. Avoid the high heat. The recommendation is to put 2 pillows per wash to balance the load. And also then use dry balls or tennis ball in the dryer if you're drying your pillows. And I stated here how to go about drying the different pillows, okay? If your pillows get yellow, don't throw them out. And you know we go through pillows like crazy. So wash them in a hot water with a cup of laundry detergent, some dishwasher detergent, bleach, borax, and let them soak. Then what you do is then you wash them. And you might want to wash them more than once, but that will totally well, Juliet, when the pillows get lumpy, if you put a tennis ball or dry balls, it beats them in the dryer. So it's the only time that I recommend anything getting beaten is on your pillows in the washer, all right? Because then what happens is the substances, the lumpiness comes away. So that's the solution, is tennis balls in the dryer when you are washing your towel and your pillows. For keeping your whites white, the recommendation is to use very hot water and then choose one of these alternatives, all right? So you're not gonna do all of them, you're just gonna take one of them. So you either use a laundry booster, and that's best with soft water, and you will know if you have hard water in your house or not. So from borax, oxygen, bleach, or washing soda. Or you could use a quarter water, a cup of water softener, half a comma ammonia only. Or you could also have, you have other options. You could use white vinegar, lemon juice, white bride. And if you're going to use Mrs. Stewart's, and that's not associated with Martha Stewart at all, it's a bluing agent, but you have to make sure that you dilute it first, because if not, things will turn blue. Okay, so these are just different options that you could use to clean and keep the whites white. Remember that I don't, hi George, I see your question about guest smoke in your room, and I will send you, send me an email, because I actually got some information about removing smell of odors, but I'm not talking about that here right now. I will do a post about that later on in the future. Right now, we're just going to be talking laundry and very general stuff, because if not, believe me, this, we could talk about this for hours. All right. So basically, this is, you know, one of the things, this is to keep your whites white. Remember, the whites are going to, you're doing a lot of laundry, you're doing a lot of loads and everything else, and you want to keep your whites pristine. So remove some, no, I don't mean alcohol vinegar, I mean white vinegar. It's the white vinegar that you use for cooking, okay? And it's very, very inexpensive, okay, Tola? So, I'm sorry, I'm just trying to, do you guys have any more questions for getting makeup? Oh, I have a thing about makeup. So, removing stains. In reference of coffee, we have for fresh coffee stains, and we have for so dry coffee stains. You could, the fresh coffee you use, you could flush the stain with cold water, rub a little ice, put a clean towel behind the garment so the coffee is taken out onto something else. But this has to be a garment, a clean towel that you don't care staining, okay? And then if the remains, the stain remains, use a little white vinegar. Excuse me a minute, I need water. And then rinse it, okay? With dry coffee, and I'm talking about a little bit about the stains that we commonly see, since we are host and this is what people tend to do. So if you have dry coffee, you just do the same thing with a clean wet towel. You spray shaving cream, and then you blot it. If the stain remains, you rub a paste of baking soda and water on the stain. Let it sit for an hour and plot it again, okay? Now, before, if you have something with a stain, before you wash it, please make sure that your stain is removed and gone. All right, so this is about chocolate, and I'm not going to give you all the specifications because I'm giving you this deck, and I know it's 6:13 already, and we have a lot of material to go through. So I have from stains with chocolate, here, Tilda is the one with, I'm sorry, Christy, with makeup, because it depends on what kind of makeup is it that you're removing. So from liquid foundation, and believe me, it is one of the biggest problems that we have, that women do not, or men, do not remove their makeup. I hope you're offering makeup removers, which is a great option for your guests. And what you do is just get them a little bit of a container with makeup removers and tell them, hey, please use that. Instead of the towels. No, yeah, Suzanne, I am going to be giving you this presentation. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about keeping track and writing things down. I am going to share the whole presentation with you guys. So don't worry. Is that okay? All right, so we have blood. Sometimes people have a blood, a nosebleed, and we've all seen it. So this is with fresh blood. Use a little bit of white vinegar on the stain before it sets. Let it soak, plot it, and repeat, okay? And then wash it immediately. And Juliet, you're not only gonna be able to access it later, and we're going to send you all this information. Thank you so much, Gringo, for letting her know. With dry blood, the recommendation is hydrogen peroxide. So clean it with a clean, scrub it with a clean rag, pour a little bit more hydrogen peroxide and let it sit for 5 minutes. Then one of the things that I heard was you use a hot iron on the stain, and this will remove the stain. If there's a little bit of a ring because of the hot iron, And Kathy, you know, I do use chlorine bleach right now, but they are not recommending that. And it's something that I really want to change. I want to stop using chlorine bleach and go a little bit more environmentally because chlorine bleach is just not good for the environment right now. Okay. So this is for smell. You know how sometimes your towels, they might sit in the dryer and you forgot them or something like that. The recommendation is to use hot water and a cup of white vinegar or hot water and half a cup of baking soda. Okay. Yeah, liquid chocolate, it's hard to remove. And I'm gonna share a deck. I got a PDF from that Martha Stewart has with all the different stains and removers. One of the things that I did not know that I found out doing all this research was that we need to clean our washer. Who knew, right? So, I mean, I don't know if you guys do this or not, but clean your washer, and I'm giving you instructions on how to clean it, the top load and the front load. So the top load, you have to do this about twice a year, and I have not done laundry today because I want to try it out. And then the front load, you should do this about once a month. Had the needs cold water after the peroxide. Well, Juliet, this is what I was reading. Please, I mean, I think we could try it on something that doesn't work. And I mean, but it was something a good source on the internet. Of course, you know, the internet lies. But give it a shot. So this is a little bit about oxygen bleach and chlorine bleach, and I'm gonna leave this after washing and dry it. Christina, you were talking about that the sheets get oily type stains. You have to do when you remove your sheets or the person that is doing your laundry or changing over your space, they need one of the things that I recommend is to look at the towels and the sheets, spray them with shower or with cleaner. So like that, you're attacking the stain before it gets washed and set. Once it gets set into the dryer, it just the stain is really hard to remove again because it's just set into the fibers of the materials. All right. So to do a little quick cleaning of the bathroom, which is one of the biggest things that we have to do for our guest. And a little side note, I just had a guest who had stayed with me last year, and they're at an Airbnb in another country, and they sent me a text last night, telling me that where they were staying was very dirty. And they were asking me what to do, and what I recommended her was to talk to the host and to put all the communications with the through the Airbnb side. So please know that your guests are very aware of your cleaning. I know that you're great cleaners because you're here. So I know that you know you take this seriously. All right. So for a quick cleaning of the bathroom is you apply the cleaner to the shower and the bathtub. You let it sit. While that is sitting and cooking, you apply the cleaner to the toilet and the sink, and you let that sit. You work in the shower and the tub from the top to the bottom when you're cleaning, so the dirt is going down instead of, you know, if you wash the tub and then you wash the tiles, it's sort of you are now the dirt is coming back into the tub. So you then rinse the shower and tub with water, you scrub your walls and everything else, you clean your toilet, don't forget the floor and behind the toilet, especially if you have guys because they might miss things. You clean your sink. You spray your mirror with the cleaner and wiper, wipe it. And what I tend to do is the same paper towel that I use with the mirror. I clean the handles, so give them a good shine. Empty and wipe the waste basket. Don't forget to wipe the light switch and the doorknobs. Please replace your bath mat. I understand that you're thinking that your mat bath mats, you're coming out of your wash out of taking a shower and you're clean, but when you stepped onto your shower, you're sweaty, your feet might be dirty. I replace my mat bath mat every guest. I don't give them a used bath mat by somebody else. It's one of my pet peeves. I know of hosts that they just shake it because they feel that that's enough. I personally don't, and I hope that please change your bath mats. Vacuum your floor, then mop it, and then vacuum it one more time, looking for any stray hairs, all right? Because the worst thing to do is for somebody to go into your bathroom and they see a stray black hair, especially my hair, that happens a lot. For a deeper clean, what you do is empty the medicine cabinet, throw out any expired meds, clean the shelves, return the items, clean the light fixtures, dust the blinds, clean the window. It's a great thing to clean windows. It just gives the room such a great feeling. Clean the baseboards, clean picture frames, and clean the walls. This is a little bit of a deeper cleaning, and hopefully you'd be able to do this about once a month. Yeah, and actually, Gina, I have a tip for the shower. If you have mildew on the showers, use 10 parts water to 1 part bleach. Let it sit, brush it, clean with a sponge, and then follow with a pH neutral cleaner. Please Google pH neutral cleaner, because it was a lot of different things, all right? So you feel that the broom tip picks up better than a vacuum cleaner? Yeah, I don't. My broom, I don't know. I guess I need to replace my broom. For your shower door and your tiles, use a squeegee after every shower. So, and you could even tell your guests to do this. If you're sharing your space with your guests, you could tell them, hey guys, you know, can you please just clean the shower so like that it doesn't get scummy. If you get scum, and this is something I'm going to try out this week, is a paste of baking soda with water. You just apply it on the wall, on the door, and then with a non-scratch sponge, and then you rinse it with white vinegar. All right. To clean the shower track, it's pour the white vinegar, let it sit. Oh, we have a typo. Scrub with brush and rinse. You mean to clean your walls? Well, what you do on the shower is you use a cleaner, whatever cleaner you use for your tub, you could use it on your wall, and then you just use a sponge to clean it out. What you do is you pour hot water on it so that it dissolves any dirt, okay? I hope I answer your question, Juliet. Or do you mean the walls on the bedroom itself? Because if you mean that, what I normally use is I use a little wipe. If there are stain, I tend to use Mr. Clean Erase Magic. You just have to be careful because it will take the paint off your walls. I know, Kathy, I believe me. And he's a great host. And I'm like, please share, change the bat mat. For the toilet, if it's a little bit bad, just pour a little, have a cup of chlorine bleach, let it sit, stand for 15 minutes. If you have hard water rings, instead of the chlorine bleach, please use white vinegar, or you could use a pumice stone with the handle and it will remove it. Okay, so the painter walls, Juliet, what I use to clean them is basically a rag and wool, and I've never used a steamer for cleaning the toilet. I don't know, and I have, in all the research I've done, I didn't see anybody using a steamer for cleaning the toilets. I don't even know how you would go about it. So Juliet, in reference of the walls, if the walls are a little bit yellow, if anybody smokes in your house or anything like that, if it's a smoking house, you will get yellow walls. So my recommendation is use Mr. Clean Erase Magic. The cleaner is in the sponge, wet it a little bit, and you will see the dirt come off the walls. It's really like, wow. Okay. I also use handy wipes for the walls. Just give them a good little, you know, as I go along, so things don't get too grubby. All right. If you have mold in your shower curtains, and I know somebody mentioned that. Yes. So, well, you know what I do, Suzanne, with the liner cleaning is I buy a washable liner cleaner, liner. So what I do is a machine washable. I have two, so when I'm washing one, the other one is up. There is one from Sears that I really like because it does not have an edge at the bottom. the Bed Bath & Beyond brand has like those little cardboard at the bottom of the liner that it gets moldy, and even if you clean it, it doesn't feel and it does not look clean. So what I would recommend is basically wash your shower curtains with one cup of white vinegar and the towels. So, and then you just remove them from the washer before the spin cycle. And one of the things that I read, and I have not tried this, believe me, I'm looking forward to trying this, is use baby oil along the edge of the shower curtain liner, not on your outer curtain, okay? Yes, one of the things that I read about mold, it's also to turn on your fan, because mold means that it's the room is a little bit too wet also, okay? Now, so when you have a clogged shower head, a good thing to do is put vinegar, white vinegar again, in a plastic bag. You secure the bag over the shower head with a rubber band and let it soak. You could also remove the shower head and just put it in a bowl, cover it with vinegar, make sure that the shower head is submerged, and then just clean it out, and it will take out all the minerals from the shower head. Okay? I know, hot. Once a month, one of the great things to do is to pour half a cup of baking soda. Then you pour half a cup of vinegar, and it's gonna foam. It's actually really pretty. You let it sit, and then you add boiling water. That will get rid of clogs and things like that, and it's actually a great way to clean your pipes, okay? I mean, you could do it in the sink, and you could do it also in the tub, all right? So anybody has any more questions about the bathroom? Are we good? So for Blank, she's saying, so to help, yeah, keep the curtains, yes, definitely keep your curtains closed, because if you have them bunched up, they will create mold, all right? And mildew, and they get yucky. We don't want yucky things. So the six items that we forget about in the kitchen, I know we do like that surface clean and make sure that everything is done, but some things that we forget is, one of them is a coffee maker, and I have instructions on how to clean the coffee maker. And again, I'm gonna give you this so you have all these instructions, but it's great to do this at least every couple of months or so, so like that your coffee and your guest coffee, even if you don't drink coffee, but imagine you have a coffee maker for your guests and you're not doing like what I did at the beginning of my hosting career, that I didn't have a coffee maker for my guest. They were like, "Oh, coffee?" All right, so another thing that we forget to clean is the dishwasher. If you have a dishwasher, you need to clean it about once a month. It's a very intensive project. My dear Jason was telling me, "What, you're doing this and with a toothpick? Oh my God." But it's a great thing to do, because you gotta remember, particles of food get in there, not everything gets gone, it's gone. So you have, and don't forget the seals around the dishwasher. They get crummy and they get yucky, and you have to clean them so the dishwasher works properly and it looks clean for your guests as well. All right. So here are a couple of alternatives on how to go about cleaning your dishwasher. You know, you could baking soda and things like that. And if you have mold or mildew, you run the dishwasher with a half a cup to a cup of chlorine bleach only. Do not use it if you have stainless steel, and please do not mix bleach and vinegar. It's very toxic. Okay. So those are some instructions for the dishwasher. Another item that we forget to clean, just because it's a little bit higher up, is the microwave. This is some instructions on how to go about doing a deeper cleaning of your microwave. Something interesting that I found out is that if you put a wooden toothpick or a wooden object like chopsticks into a vinegar water bowl, it would avoid exploding all over. So that's something good for you guys to know. So half a cup of white vinegar and water in a bowl, put a little wooden toothpicks. You heat the bowl for 5 to 10 minutes, depending on how dirty your microwave is. Let it sit for a minute or two. use oven mitts to remove the bowl, and then clean the inside of your microwave with a sponge. And don't forget to remove the turntable, and don't forget to also clean the front of your microwave. This is another alternative cleaning method, which is with lemon juice, all right? So you put, instead of white vinegar, you use lemons and the juice of a lemon. All right, so another item that we tend to forget, especially for places that our guest has fully, or even if we share with guests, I sometimes I'm like, oh my God, the refrigerator needs to be clean. And I tend to give it a good cleaning whenever I go food shopping to wipe down all the shelves, but sometimes you have to take everything out and remove things. And yeah, exactly, Vicky, thank you. Yes, you put the lemon in the water and everything else. Yes, food covering, it's a good thing. I mean, but what happens is, guys, we have, unfortunately, we have guests that use, if you're sharing your kitchen with your guests, that they will use it and will not cover the food, or they will do some spills and things happen and they might not be as clean as we want them to be. All right, so don't forget to clean your refrigerator, and also don't forget to clean the seal around your refrigerator, all right? So these are just some instructions and also alternative for chemical-free. And then the fifth one is the kitchen sink. We sometimes forget how that the kitchen sink, even though we're cleaning dishes and all of that, it needs to be cleaned. One of the things you could do is use baking soda on the sink. You scrub it. This is for a stainless steel sink. And you scrub it with a soft sponge. You rinse it with white vinegar. If the baking soda is still active, it will fizzle. And you lightly rub it, the sponge, and rinse it with water. Then you rub the skin of lemon or orange peel against the stainless steel. And for you to buff it with a little bit of paper towel and a drop of olive oil. So it's really good to keep your stainless steel sink, and you could do this and it lasts for a while. To clean a porcelain sink, you mix baking soda and ammonia in a bucket, and then you soak a sponge and clean the sink with that. Okay, so don't pour it in the sink, you put it separately. And the next one is the trash bin. We forget, and food gets dumped in it. Sometimes the garbage bags will break and things like that. Yeah, don't forget under the rims if you have insert sinks, please. Those things get really, really yucky. So don't forget to clean your trash bin. If you have space outside, take it outdoors and clean it. If you don't, just clean it in the bathtub before you clean your tub, something like that. You clean your tub afterwards. If you're going to use bleach or ammonia, do not mix them together. So make sure that you use either or. And then just let it sit for 30 minutes. And then just clean it with a broom or a long handle brush. And make sure that it's air dry. I actually like to place a little bit of baking soda at the bottom of my trash bin. I haven't read it anywhere, but that's something that I do. So that's something. In reference of cleaning green, and this is something that I've had guests, numerous guests, that have asked me about, it's my house, how do I clean it, that they have sensitivities to scents, that they have sensitivities to chemicals. So one of the things that I'm recommending our hosting community is to clean green, to go with natural products. Remember that even if a cleaner say that it's green, it doesn't mean much, because there's no standard for the government. There's no standards in reference of what environmental friendly it is. So it's better to use your white vinegar, your baking soda, your ammonia, the products that you have at home. Okay. So one of the things is your guests would appreciate that you're not using chemicals in the house. You could announce it in your description. You could tell them, hey, this is a green home, and I know of a host that does this, that she has, it's on her page. She announces very much, it's a new market for your listing, where it's sort of like, hey, oh, look, we have a Gina from the Philippines. My friend Jason Gina is going to the Philippines in 4 days. Yay, Philippines. I just got excited about that. So you spend less money, and stuff, of course, it's better for the environment. So I'm giving you on the presentation a bunch of different recipes and do it yourself, from Shout to bathroom wipes. One of the biggest confusion, you could use a rag and also use newspapers for your, one of the things that I've been reading a lot is microfibers, cloths, and I haven't used them yet, so I don't know how best they are, Juliet. I don't know if you use them, so you could just tell us a little bit about it. But this is how to do a bathroom wipe, and my dear friend Jason and I, we were really confused about how to explain this, because what you do is you take a paper roll and you cut it in half horizontally, right? We don't know how to say this. Like you have two halves of a paper roll, all right? And then you place it in a container that it could fit, and then you pour the previous mixture of the lemon juice, the water, the rubbing alcohol, the baking soda, and your liquid soap in this container with your half of paper towel, and that becomes your wipes, your bathroom wipes. And that's something that, you know, if your container has a lid, make sure that you seal it, make a little hole in it, or just remove the cardboard tube and you pull from the inside, you know, where the tube was at. All right. I don't know. Believe me, we were debating about how to explain this. And my excuse is English is not my first language. I don't know what his excuse is. So this is carpet finish, and then just a couple of other cleaning tips. And then I'm providing you, this has all of these links are live. So when you get the presentation, you could clean on it, you could click on the link and it will send you to them. So this is the presentation for today, and I just want to have enough time for some Q&A, and also if anybody wants to, for me to look at your Airbnb. This is part of what I offer when I give you a one-on-one consultation. I just don't teach you about how to do your listing and your description, but I also give you insights on how to work better and how to use your finances better, and what to offer your guests in a way that they would just totally, totally love you, all right? So do we have any questions? I have, the last question is from Juliet about the microfiber. I didn't know that it was a petroleum byproduct. So thank you for letting you know. I know there's so much stuff that we can learn in reference of cleaning green and everything else. And just keep us informed, people, that just go in and do more research and find out what you could do and not use in your home. It's not just better for you, but it's better for the environment, and it's better for your guests, and your guests will totally appreciate it. I am not seeing any questions. I don't know if the chat is just not updating. What's the name of the sheets? Oh, the sheets that I love, it's the Threshold. The Threshold is the brand that I like. It's actually, I have a blog post on my site. For the space to smell good, it would be great to, you could boil some water with some lemon slices. Something that I do, especially during the Christmas season, is boil, pour some cinnamon sticks and water and boil that. And that gives a natural scent to the house. I don't really use chemicals. I'm very allergic to certain things and scents, and I have sensitivity to scents. So those will be my recommendations. You gotta remember that clean does not have a smell. Clean does not have this, you know, Febreze or chemical smell. So if you want something to smell a little nicer, you could either use essential oils, you could use some lemon, you could use something a little bit more natural, some orange peels and things like that, that will give you a scent to the space without being overwhelming. And you also don't know what your guests might be allergic to. Some hosts like to spray things, and it sort of becomes a little bit like, I don't know, okay? So do we have any questions? yeah, I'm a little sweaty, it's hot in here. My God, it's hot in the house. Do You talk about it's really hard. Really, it's hard to find white vinegar. I'm surprised. I always think that white vinegar is everywhere in the world. But I've been to Argentina. I love your country. One of my favorites in the world. So does anyone wants me to look at your listing? Please pop in your Airbnb listing so we can all look at it. You have to be brave for that because it will be, everybody will see it. Yeah, cinnamon and sugar. Oh my God, look at that. I use cinnamon and clove sticks. Kathy, you're welcome. I'm so glad that, and I hope. You see, you could tell, Gringo, you live in a very Spanish Miami because you're using Fabuloso. Fabuloso is this product that is very Latin. And of course, it just, you know, chemicals and all that other stuff, but you know. It's just what we use. And when you smell a place that has Fabuloso, you could tell that it's a Spanish place. Yes, I will be, Claire, Vicky, I will be Evelyn, I will be emailing the presentation in a couple of days once I do a recap of everything. How often do I dust walls? Oh, wall art. In the I trying to do it like once a week. It's just dust is everywhere. Juliet, if you want us to look at your listing right now, we can just do it without a fee. This is just something that I tried doing. All right, Christina, we have a volunteer. So, Christina, you are allowing me to look at your listing and share it with our lovely, lovely people. And I'm going to. That's beautiful. That's so pretty. Oh, look at you. So you in New Jersey. Let me share this with everybody. And mind you, please note that I'm just looking at this for the first time. And let's look at it so everybody can see it. All right. So this is Christine's cozy hardwood home for two town center. Okay. So again, as you see, I was already having a little bit of a problem with the title, probably because of my Spanish. I'm gonna tell you just a couple of things in reference. You have a queen bed. Do you offer anything else? Is it a cozy home? Is a private room? My question is, you're saying that they could use the kitchen, but I'm not, and you're saying two bedrooms are available. All right, so I'm gonna tell you a couple of things, Christina. First of all, you are not giving me photos here. You have four photos over here, one of them of the cat. Does that mean the cat is, I understand that you probably don't want to look, post up all your dogs and photos. You need to do it. People are not going to go and search. It's not easy to go even to your other listing. They're not, it's harder for them to go and start looking for them. You got to make it easy for them. So my first recommendation is for you to post as many photos as possible of the place, of all the things that they have access to. If you have a cat and the cat is in the living room space of the guest, I will recommend for you to put it somewhere here on about this listing. Short workshops from original wood paneling and pine floors. Yeah, I mean, you have to put all those photos. So that's my first recommendation to you. All right, so because we're moving quickly with this, let's go with Celery, our next participant on our quick run away. All right, so let me share the screen so you guys can see this. A relaxing condo with a view of the city. All right, so what makes it relaxing? Let's find out. Okay, so relaxing condo with view of the city. As you see from the first photo, I would like to probably see that relaxing view. I want to see that view from the city. What is it that I'm seeing? You have a lot of photos of the bedroom. Some of them are duplicated. This is a beautiful space, very nice and clean. I love it. You did a great job with the photos, setting up the table and everything else. But you talk about a view, and I'm not seeing a view. I'm up to page 15, photo 16. Actually, and I like these photos better. I like the duvet cover has a better personality than your first one. Because on the first photo, let me see here. I'm trying to move to the first photos. You see, you selected the one that is solid gray, and it doesn't have as much personality as the other side in the other photos. You're duplicating photos. It is too many of them. You could pare this down after photo 15. Guests move on. Remember, you have a guest is going through spaces and through different listings. My recommendation is your photo 17. Let me see how this is just not moving back. 17 right here. This is a pretty photo. And also you need to show that photo of that view that you're talking about, because I'm not seeing it. And I'll all the way up to 30, 39. Yeah, you are talking about something that you're not showing me. So you need to show me that relaxing with the view of the city. And why is it that makes this a relaxing? Are you in the Philippines? This is the place in the Philippines, beautiful place. All right, so that was for celery. Ed, let's go to the next one. And I'm only gonna select three more. Oh, I've seen this. Ed, I checked your space out the other day and I was in love with it. I love the peacock. All right, the reference of Explore Miami, I don't think it's good on the headline because I think you have other things. And I think your about this listings could be beefed up a little bit better. Are people concerned about safety? If that's something that they ask on your on their questions, then I will put that about safety. If not, I will put it in the description and not on about this listing. I actually seen your space before, which I love. I totally love it. If you have a photo, and I love that the peacock is like right there hanging out. It's just, I mean, this is amazing. And I'm not showing you guys the place. Oh, you have to see this. I'm sorry. Let me share the screen because I'm excited about the space. All right. Okay. So this is his space. This is Ed. Look at this, guys. A peacock in your backyard. This is a beautiful photo. It is just so great. I wish that his, I don't know, how do you call it? His feathers were open. Is that how you say it? I don't know. I guess so. Jason does not want you to hear him. But yeah, I wish you had a photo with his feathers open and beautiful. I like the photos you have. You do have a lot of photos of the outside space, which is great. And I like your little "don't mind the other guest" caption. It's very cute. But you're repeating some photos of the outside, and I would like to see more of the inside sooner. So your photo number 14 and 15 could be moved ahead. Do they have a private bathroom, Ed? Because if you have a private bathroom, oh, you have a photo with, look at that, number 20. If the guest has a private bathroom on this shared space, you need to put that on the title. So Pika plays with private bathroom. Forget about Explore Miami. They know that they're searching Miami. You do not need to use that on your headline, all right, on your listing name. So instead of using that, I want you to use Pika plays bedroom with private bathroom. Your private bathroom trumps everything else, okay?
Skip Suzanne.
Oh, and I skipped Suzanne. No, I'm sorry, Suzanne. Let me go to Suzanne. No, I had Christina, Celery, Ed. I'm going down from the bottom. I didn't see Suzanne's place. All right, so that's Ed's reco. I have next Juliet. I'm sorry, I'm going through the list from who raised their hands first. And I'm not going to be able to go through all of you guys tonight because it is 6:15. All right. Oh, Juliet. Oh, you guys are experts. You guys are already like really doing this so well. This is a great photo, and I like it. You know, I don't think you need to on your caption front of, let me just share the screen since I'm not sharing it. Jason, tell me which one is it that I missed so that I could. All right, let me share the screen. All right, so in your front caption, you say in front of the house. We already know it. You don't need to say that. I think we're 20-minute drive to Beale Street. I imagine that is something that people have a people they are interested about. I like photo number two, but I know photo number one, it's a lot better. I think, let's look at, you see, you have three photos in a row of the, four photos in a row of the bedroom. I don't know if you offer, different spaces. Do they have a private bathroom? Let me just check. So you could put this, is this, if you have, okay, yeah, no. You need to put the private bathroom up first as photos and even maybe in your listing title. Again, really, if you are sharing an apartment, if you are offering a private bedroom and you have a private bathroom, that trumps everything. Really, it just does. This is beautiful. Photo number 12 of your living room, you could bring it up, especially if you allow your guests to be in that space. Oh, I love your photo, Juliet and Ed. Look at you guys. A happy host. If, do you allow your guests to play with the fire? Then photo number 16 could be put up, especially now that the winter is coming, unfortunately. Okay. Do you allow them to cook? Because you're saying if you want to do some cooking, just ask. If you not allow them to cook, I will not show the kitchen. And I will just leave that as a as an option later on when you have the tour. Just don't put the kitchen. Just I know you're saying that you provide breakfast. No pets, private bathroom. I don't think you need to say completely renovated. So yeah, you have a private bathroom. Of course you do. Beautiful home. I think, yeah, I would just say, because you see when you go down on your listing page, what you have is that you have the beautiful photo of the home, but you already showed that before. And you have four photos up front of your bedroom. So my recommendation is to do another photo of one of the private bathroom and one of the living room because they're beautiful. And so just showcase that. Okay. Yeah, if you allow them, but you see what I got, Julia, from your photo, say ask, just ask. It means that they have to ask for permission. All right. Okay. I'm doing one more and that's it, and this is for you guys to come back, or if you want me to look at your listing in private, you could hire me just for even half an hour, and we could just do a very in-depth conversation. We could talk about everything and all the questions that you have. So from Vietnam, I'm sorry I cannot pronounce your last name, and oh wow, okay, let's show this one. Let me give you guys this view. This is beautiful. All right. I really actually do enjoy doing this, especially because you guys are good with it. All right. This is a great photo. Celery, you had the place with the views before. This is, look at that. You see the view right away. It's a penthouse with amazing views. Yes, it is. So this is in Vietnam. And this is a beautiful view. Now, you showing me three photos, one after the other of the views. You could do with the first one because it's the first thing, and then you can move on. This is a good photo, but I'm seeing mostly floor. And it's a little bit too far from the kitchen, so what you see, it's a lot more of the floor than anything else. As you see, it's beautiful, shiny floors, and just a beautiful space. Wow, this place is huge. But I kind of wish it was like, you see photo number 8 is a little bit closer. So probably, or even photo number 9, I wish it was a little brighter. So probably take this size of the photo from before. I even like number 10. These are good photos. And photo number 13 needs to be a little closer. I don't know if, I guess this is a separate bedroom, number 14. Oh, wow, this is beautiful. Number 17, beautiful, beautiful bed. So these are great photos. You have one that it's a little cloudy. Oh, number 19, you have stuff there that's clouding the space. I will probably remove that because you have another photo, number 20, with the bathroom. You have a lot of photos of food. Oh, I guess this is you. You can move that upper head forward. You have a great space. And I think you will definitely do well. This is your escape. I would recommend, I don't know if what your audience tends to be more Americans or European, besides giving them in the metric system, put it down also in the American, what is our system? What is it called? Metric, not metric, the feet and, you know, we're backwards. So that will be my recommendation is reference of your photos. Just show the photos a little bit closer, because remember that a guest is going to be looking through your space. So that will be my last quick speedy review for today. Please remember to just continue your efforts in learning. I'm going to post this presentation. I'm going to send it to you, of course. I share it with my subscribers, and now that you are part of my webinars and everything else, you're part of the subscribers, and you will be getting not just the stuff, but all the other goodies that I tend to send to my lovely subscribers. If you did not read my log, Imperial System, thank you so much, Anne. I don't know the name. I just did not know the name. I know the European, it's the metric system, which is what we're supposed to be in or what we should be in. If you have not read the last blog post that I posted last week, please go to the site and read it. I give some very specific tips about protecting your account. There's something that happened in Thailand with a super host. It's very concerning for, yeah, please rearrange the photos. It's very concerning to all of us. Please protect yourself, protect your account, and just be safe. If you want to contact me for some consultation work, it will be my honor to to look at your listing, to provide you with any feedback, to tell you exactly how to go about writing your description, writing your headline, writing your about this listing. I have templates that I share from how to communicate with your guests, your reservations, your first communication with your guests, and how to go about even dealing with guests that are not great. I just received a non-positive review from a guest the other day, and it took me a while to go back and actually even decide if I was going to answer him or not. So even after 5 years, things happen that you don't expect, and you have to just go, and every experience is a little bit different. But remember that we're here, we love what we do, we love our guests, but we also love our lives, and just be well, all right? Thank you so much for spending this Sunday with me. And if you have any questions, I'm going to close the visual just so that I can put my hair up, but I'm gonna stay a little bit longer on the chat. So if you have any questions, just please let me know. I'm not going to review any more listings. But next time when I ask, come on over and tell me to review your listing, bring it up quickly, and I'm going to be doing this in every webinar, so, because I really do love seeing everybody's different places and just giving you some quick actionable steps, all right? So thank you so much, and have a great Sunday.